So quickly draw the graph of question number 5 of your worksheet. Y is equal to negative 1 by x minus 3 minus 4. Go step by step. Start with the skeleton graph. Then see what transformation you should start applying onto that function.
So negative 3 meaning should you shift it to the left?
Yeah, it's the same thing. It means the same thing as doing this. Y plus 4 is equal to negative of 1 by x minus 3. It's the same thing. There's no difference between these two. Done? Who is done? Is it? Yes. Both the arms will simultaneously move. See, the graph of 1 by x, these are not two different graphs. They are part of, their arms of the same graph. It's like it is my two arm. If you shift me, both my arms will move, isn't it? It's not like this arm will leave there and I will move like this. Correct? They are connected. Yeah. So where I go up, down, these both arms will go up together. Yes or no?
Both will
move by the same amount wherever you are moving it. Both will turn also by the same way. Getting the point? I'm not saying right or wrong to anybody. I want to see how you are bringing about that transformation. X minus 3 is shifting the graph, 3 is the right.
The
both arms will move 3. Same thing. If you're replacing x with x minus 3, the entire graph will move 3 to the right. Now, whether it's in x minus 3 whole cube form or whether it's 1 by x form, it doesn't make a difference.
I got up here, I don't know what you mean. Negative.
Now, here, negative. We can't make a negative because if you are making negative, either x will become negative or just y will become negative. You want both things to become negative, right? So negativity has to be done before you meet the x minus 3. That's when the order becomes important. That's what I was explaining you. Guys, be careful at what junction you have to change the sign, because after changing y with y plus 4 and x with x minus 3, you cannot change the sign then. Then if you are changing the sign, only x or only y will change, if at all you are changing them. Done? Shaunak, right? Shaumik. Okay. I think Ronak, Shaumik. Okay. Yeah. We'll discuss. Okay. Let's go step by step. Shh. All of you please pay attention to this. First, I would start with 1 by x, which I have already drawn for you. Okay. Next, what should I do, tell me? Should I replace the sign of x right now?
Y.
Y or x doesn't matter, actually. If I change my sign of y or if I change my sign of x, does it really bring any difference to my final outcome? So if you reflect the graph about y-axis or if you reflect this graph about x-axis, end result is same. You can check it out. If you reflect it like this, it will become like this. It is the same as reflecting the graph about x-axis also. Okay. Yeah. So you want to change the sign of x. Okay, let's follow this. So what will be the graph for this then? Changing the sign of x means reflecting the graph about y-axis. So let me choose. Is that fine? So blue one is now the graph of y is equal to.
So you have to change both arms.
Okay. Huh?
Both
arms. That's why I told you, no. It's like this, let's say. And you're making me like this go. So both arms will change. Get the point. So y is equal to negative 1 by x is done.
What next? Should I change my x with x minus 3?
Yeah.
So when I change my x with x minus 3,
shift it to what?
I will shift this blue graph 3 units to the right. Understood? So if I'm shifting it 3 units to the right, now tell me, will it change the horizontal asymptote or will it change its vertical asymptote?
Horizontal.
Vertical.
Vertical will change. So it will become like this. Understood? Is this understood? So you are shifting this blue graph 3 units to the right. That means now, instead of having y axis as the asymptote, or instead of having x equal to 0 as the asymptote, now your new asymptote will be x equal to 3. Understood? Now, what next I have to do? How would I get y plus 4? Replace y with y plus 4. If you rechange your y with y plus 4, the same graph
will go
down by 4 units. So what will change? Will it change its horizontal asymptote or will it change its vertical asymptote?
Horizontal
asymptote. So now the final graph, I'm drawing it in red color. The final graph, all of you please watch here. The final graph would appear like this. I'm drawing it on the same graph, so it may look a bit hodgepodge. But now this is your y is equal to negative 4 line. So ultimately, I'm drawing a miniature version over here. Your graph will look like this. Understood? I will show you step by step on GeoGebra. Okay. Y is equal to 1 by X.
So what I hate about it.
Is that fine? Is that fine? Now, first step that we did was we changed x as negative x. Correct? So what I will do is, blue graph, I will hide this. Okay?
Amazing.
Next, what did I do? I changed x with x minus 3. Okay? I hide the previous one.
Shifted 3 units
to the
right.
Right. Now your new asymptote will be x equal to 3 line. You see this line? This line will be asymptote, means this will appear to touch the curve at infinity. Okay. Hide this also. Don't need this. Now, I'm changing y with y plus 4. I'll make the change here itself. You see that? It went down.
1.
Right? Now this line that you see, y is equal to minus 4, that will be your horizontal asymptote, and x equal to 3 will be your vertical asymptote. Understood? Now this missing part is because of the graphic issue. Yeah. Is it fine? Understood how it works?
Okay.
Understood what is happening? So what is happening is, from this position, it is now going to a position where this asymptote has shifted 3 units to the right and this asymptote has shifted 4 units down. So something like this is happening. So you can just plot a graph in this fashion.
The turning point is 3 comma minus
4. There's no turning point here, I'll talk about it. Okay. Is this fine? Okay. Quickly, without wasting much time, we can talk about... Yeah, somebody had a question here. How do you plot the graph of 1 by x squared? This arm will remain Okay, so it will become like this. Why is that so? Why I don't have a graph below the x-axis?
The positive value.
The reason is the presence of a square over here. It's because of that square, your y will never become a negative value. Right? Achha, what will happen when you cube it?
Negative. You mean the same thing like x.
Somebody said very correctly, it will be the same as 1 by x, but it will be narrower. Can you tell me where will it be narrower?
The same 1 and negative 1.
Now, the good time to look at it is your GeoGebra. So first of all, I'll show you y equal to 1 by x squared. Y is equal to 1 by x squared. Is this fine? Is that fine? Okay. Now, let me just reopen it again. I will show you the comparison between 1 by x and 1 by x cube. Okay, 1 by x. Y is equal to 1 by x cube. Do you see the difference? Now again, the difference is after 1 and before minus 1. Now see what is happening over here. Of course, at 1 and minus 1, both of them will give you the same value. Correct? What is happening after 1? If I talk about y is equal to 1 by x and y is equal to 1 by x cube. If I take value of x as 2, let's say, which is higher, 1 by 2 or 1 by 2 cube?
1 by 2
is higher. So you can see that the graph of the green one, which is 1 by x, is the higher graph. Is the higher graph of the blue and the green one, isn't it? But before, let's say between 0 and 1, I take a value like x is equal to half. So y is equal to 1 by half, which is 2. And y is equal to 1 by half cube, which is 8. Which is more? 1 by x cube is more. So you can see that the blue graph dominates the graph of 1 by x. The blue is the graph of this one. This is your blue graph. So between 0 and 1, who is the boss? 1 by x cube. Yes or no? After 1, who is the boss? 1 by x. Okay, that's what is happening here. So value wise, magnitude wise, the graph of 1 by x is higher than the graph of 1 by x cube when you are above 1 or below minus 1. Between minus 1 to 1, the graph of 1 by x cube will have a higher value than graph of 1 by x. Simple? Achha, what will happen if I plot 1 by x to the power 5? Do one thing. On your notebook, draw the graph of 1 by x, 1 by x cube, 1 by x to the power 5 on the same xy coordinate system. And clearly show me what will happen. And if you're done, this is your 1 by x cube, 1 by x 5, all odd powers. I'll come to 1 by x square also. But there's which is the graph of 1 by x 5, okay, absolutely correct. Done?
Oh, wonderful.
Hey, draw both the arms. Most of you are just drawing single arm. It's okay, I'm not too keen on its beauty of the graph. I just want to see the relative positioning. Which is what, my dear? One by x5, one by x3, one by x3. Point. Do you realize that 1 by x5 will come like this and even go down like this? Okay, let's see whether it is happening like this. Where is my y is equal to 1 divided by x to the power of 5. You see that red one? Understood how it works? A similar nature you would also see when I draw 1 by x square and 1 by x to the power 4 and 1 by x to the power 6 and 1 by x to the power 8 like that. It's the same change in the curvature that you will also see there also. So can I show you there? So let's delete them.
So the interval is always same.
The interval is same. That 1 and minus 1 are the critical points for you. So y is equal to 1 divided by x square. Okay, this is the graph. Next, y is equal to 1 divided by x4. Do you see that? Again, 1 and minus 1 are the points to be careful about. So it is more flatter. Correct? What about 1 by x to the power 6? Let's see that. Y is equal to 1 divided by x to the power of 6. Even more flatter. Correct? So after 1, 1 by x to the power 6 is the least. Between 0 and 1, 1 by x to the power 6 is the highest. Are you getting this point? Okay. So please plot. Please plot. Question number 7. Don't get scared by that negative 2. That will not. Question number 6. Oh, sorry, question number 7. Question number 7, my bad. Question number 7. What question number 7?